on silent and shut your fucking mouth. The show is about to begin.
I've gone from 100% doing this to, oh, I don't really know, then back to, yeah, no, I'm gonna do this, and then to, nah, I'm not gonna do it. And yet, here we are, staying up to midnight to listen to Niall's new album, The Show, which comes out in 2 minutes. And I'm so tired. Let's get The Show on the road. That was so bad, I'm so sorry. I'm ripping my Heartbreak Without merch, which is actually fake merch I got from Etsy, where the lettering has started to wash off, but it's fine. I'm gonna try to put in a little more energy into this than what I did for Faith in the Future and Harry's House. Both of those reactions are quite terrible because I was so beyond tired. I really wasn't listening to the music, but Niall, you're getting better than that.
I'm not asleep, my mind is alive.
If you haven't already, go check out my reaction to Heaven and Meltdown. They are two incredibly good singles, so I'm excited to hear what the rest of the album is gonna be like. It is now officially midnight, June 9th. Let's look on Spotify. There it is. The Show, literally already adding it. It's only a 30-minute album, so I actually won't be going to bed that late, I guess. Let's just listen to it because I can't wait any longer. The Show. Opening with Heaven. Heaven can hold a candle too. You're made of something new, but that's just what we do. God only knows where this could go. And even if our love starts to grow out of control, you and me go up in flames. Heaven won't be the same. Beyond infatuation, how I obsessively adore you. That's what I do. I believe I could die in your kiss. No, it doesn't get better than this. Song still goes so hard. If you want my full reaction to that song, first time listening to it, go watch my reaction to Heaven and to the Heaven music video too. Both my channel. A little plug. Thank you, Niall. Alright, straight into a song that we haven't heard before. If You Leave Me. I'm actually quite scared. That's Taylor Swift. Excuse me? Let's go to If You Leave Me. What the heck was that? Wait. Time out. I wasn't expecting that. What? Niall? What? Here? Do you want to go here? I love that. Can't you see for the rest of my life? beautiful, Mike. I love this so much. This sounds so good. I literally can't. I was not expecting that sound at all. Not at all. That is incredible. That beat was so good. That chorus was so catchy. His voice, absolutely incredible. And then straight into Meltdown. Are you kidding me? Straight into Meltdown. When it all melts down, I'll be there. Talking to yourself in the bathroom. Losing your mind in the mirror like you have to. I do have to. Just know this to shall pass. I'm telling you now, telling you now. Ooh. When it all melts down, I'll be there. Nights when one broken glass turns to total collapse. I'm telling you now, telling you now. When there's wolves in your track, wolves in your track. Catching up fast. Catching up fast. Baby, don't you look back. Don't you look back. I live for that vocal, that one line. Oh, I cannot wait to sing that song live. All right, next song, Never Grow Up. Logically, we should be up to a slow song. Oh my gosh. The lalas like them talking over coffee, but we say nothing. I hope we still dance like we're falling in love. Hope we still drink like we're back in the pub. Stop it. Oh, but we never grow up. He's so cute. Hope we still fight over bands we love. Every single Sunday in our Sunday best. Laughing over nothing with a full wine glass. While look in her eyes. Oh, and I'm with you, yeah, it all makes sense. Never giving up on our innocence. And hope we grow old, but we never grow. I'm so obsessed with the instrumentation in all of these songs. They're so cool. His lala. The background lala. Hope we still dance like we're falling in love. Hope we still drink like we're back in the pub. Hope we grow old, but we never grow up. Stop. I can't get over those background lalas. That was lovely. That was such a cute song. I like the idea of it. I definitely think it's like the older brother version of Act My Age, like the more mature version of Act My Age. That was really nice. Here we go. Title track, the show. I'm so scared. Oh, piano. Not the piano. Mistakes and heartbreaks and no cries. Oh my gosh, Niall Horan piano breaks me. Hold tight, get ready for the ride. If everything was easy, nothing ever broke. If everything was simple, how would we know? How to fix your tears, how to fake a show. Life is like a dance floor, some of the times. Not the... Dancing with the stars, oh. Gravity comes and wraps her arms around you again. Oh my gosh, this melody is insane. If everything was easy, nothing ever broke. If everything was simple, how would we know? Okay, before we get into what I'm assuming is going to be an extremely heartbreaking bridge, the entire premise of this song is so heartbreaking. He's literally saying, like, if life was easy, how would we know how to wipe away our tears? How do we know how to fix heartbreak? How would we know to fake how to fake the show? Like, are you kidding me? If life was simple, we wouldn't know how to do these things. But if life was that simple, you wouldn't need to know how to do those things. So you'd never have to do it. He's basically implying that these things are so important to know that you're glad that life isn't simple. And it's just kind of breaking my heart, to be honest. Because all I'm thinking about in my head right now is One Direction. And even if he didn't intend for this song to be interpreted as that, like, even if this song isn't about One Direction, all I'm thinking about is the fact that, you know, their journey wasn't simple, it wasn't easy, it was hard, it wasn't fair, so now they know how to do those things. They know how to wipe away their tears, they know how to fake a show, they know how to do all this stuff, whereas if their journey was simple, if they were treated fairly, if they weren't forced to write freaking 5 albums in 5 years and go on, like, 4 world tours or however many tours they did, they wouldn't need to know how to do all those things. And it makes me want to scream. Okay, let's just get into the most probably heartbreaking bridge. Oh my gosh. I was right. I was so right. That is beautiful. If everything was easy, nothing ever broke. If everything was simple, how would we know? How could we have known? Stop this outro. So hold tight, get ready for the ride. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. You have probably heard me say on my channel a few times that I am not good at interpreting lyrics. I am not good at symbolism in songs. I don't really ever understand what a song is trying to say, but I feel like, give me half an hour, I could have an essay on that song. Now into probably the most interesting looking track, You Could Start a Cult. Oh, that's such beautiful guitar.
Darling.
Stop.
I will give up everything. Who I'll be and who I am. You can have it all.
Oh my gosh, stop it.
Oh, I follow you till there's no tomorrow.
Oh, I love him and just a guitar.
You till there's no tomorrow. I'll follow you till there's no tomorrow. I'll follow. You could start a war or two. You till there's no tomorrow.
I love that note he hits there.
You till there's no tomorrow.
It's so beautiful.
I'll follow you.
Harmonica. I was not expecting a harmonica in this album.
Baby, you could start a cult, you see. They will say that we're crazy.
I'm so glad that they didn't add, like, anything to that song, that it was just his voice and the guitar and that cheeky little harmonica and the piano at the end. But I'm glad they didn't, like, layer all that, you know. I'm glad whenever he was singing, it was just the guitar playing. All right, next song is Save My Life. Okay. Okay.
Eyes are blooming. Soul is shaking.
He sounds so good.
Now, ever since you walked in,
I'm seeing it. Oh my god.
Ever since you walked
The instrumentation at the start does remind me of that one 1975 song. I cannot remember what it's called, but while I'm editing this, I will try to find which song it is. Unless, like, when I'm editing this and I find the song, it actually sounds nothing like it, then I'm probably just going to edit this entire part out. Stop it, the harmonies. I love those little things in the background. Yes, yes, I love that little drop. Oh my gosh, a saxophone solo? I was not expecting there to be a saxophone solo on a Niall Horan album. Yes, I love that. Yep, yep. Oh, that is incredible. I love that. We only have 3 more songs, which is insane. Only a 10 song album. That's crazy. Next one, On a Night Like Tonight. Ooh. Ooh.
One in your summer skin pressed on mine, falling like rain, rippling on by. If it's this good way down here, then what's it like up there high in heaven? On a night like tonight.
What?
Pressed on mine, wanna know what your loving tastes like.
Thing. What did he just say? Did he just say, want to know what you taste like? Niall, you dirty dog.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. The instrumentation has not missed. It has not missed at all.
Baby, you blow my mind. Tell me anything you like.
Layered vocals. Oh, stop it. I love this so much. The background vocals. Okay, my. These vocals. The bells, those chimes, I love. Oh, I love that. Science. Oh, I love humming in a song so much.
Beneath, is it stone cold under your feet? Are you numb? Can you touch?
I am numb.
Is the silence a little too much?
Mm-hmm.
So when you feel there's nothing left, oh, there's still a heart beating in your chest.
Stop it, his vocals. Why does he make the best sad song? I don't understand.
Break out. So when you feel there's nothing left, all this heart beating in your chest.
He sounds so cool.
When you're running from the flood, all you've got nowhere left to run. Oh, when you feel you're sinking, oh, It's just science. Don't let it scare you now.
Oh my gosh, how does he make the best sad songs? That was so beautiful. I actually think that's like one of the most beautiful songs he's ever written. The instrumentation in that song and his vocals were absolutely insane. He's just so talented. I don't want this album to end. Now, I don't know if I want him to do what he did on Heartbreak Weather again and hit us with a still for the last track. But here we go. Last song of the album, Must Be Love. He's not pulling a still.
I'm a specialist at overthinking everything.
And just like that, the tears are gone.
I'll tell you all about it if you have the time. Or if I'm being honest, I find it so hard to just keep it simple and follow my heart. But if it feels like, la 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 la, if it feels
like, I love this. Right now, I'm so happy with this album. I'm so happy. I actually think that might be one of my fave solo albums. I have this thing where I tend to enjoy the main single on an album, which is like, it's not a big deal, but everyone is always like, oh my gosh, like that's the most overplayed song ever, and they don't like it. And I thought going into this, oh yeah, Meltdown is incredible. Nothing is gonna top Meltdown. The entire album is a bunch of no skips. It's a bunch of 10 out of 10 songs, and they're all incredible. And each one was just getting better and better and better until Must Be Love, which was just, I think, the best song on the album. But then there's If You Leave Me, which was also like the best song on the album. But then also The Show, and then Science. If listening to the snippets that I've edited wasn't enough, please do go listen to the album in its entirety. It is so amazing. So amazing. Anyways, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Thanks for cutting me off, you stupid camera.